At last, you've arrived. Good, good. There is much to do, and every moment is critical. I'm Overseer Tremel. For decades, I've administered the trials that prove who is and is not worthy to join the Sith Order. The trials are a chance to weed out the weak. Those who face them either survive and become Sith, or die.
Mark my words, I am destined to be Sith.
It wasn't destiny that brought you here. Yes, you are here and ahead of schedule because of me. I expect you to obey. You face your trials, you serve me, and I will make you the most powerful acolyte here.
You had better be able to deliver that, Tremel.
Leave your doubt at the door. There's no room for it in here. And no time to waste. The trials themselves are difficult enough, but they are hardly the greatest threat you face. There's an acolyte here named Vemrin. He's your enemy, and he will try to kill you. We must prepare you.
Let him try. I'll destroy him.
With my guidance, someday you'll destroy all your enemies. That practice sword you've arrived with is insufficient. The blade of lesser acolytes. You need a dominating weapon. In the tomb of Ajunta Paul, there's an old armory. A strong Sith warblade awaits you there. The tomb is thick with claw slugs. Deadly, savage creatures. Be speedy, but careful. They've been the end of many an acolyte.
If they lack the instinct to avoid me, I'll feed them their heads.
Once you acquire the warblade, I suggest you spend some time in the tomb bloodying it. Then come to me in my chambers in the academy.
Excuse me, Acolyte. Sergeant Corman, 5th Infantry Company, Corriban Regiment. Can I talk to you?
Speak freely, Sergeant.
Thank you. You're the Acolyte Overseer Tremel had brought in special, right? Heading down in the tomb to show what you're made of.
Mind your business, soldier.
Apologies if I offended. I thought you might appreciate the chance to not only show off for the Overseers, but build some ties with the Imperial military as well. I'm here commanding a hard-target mission to exterminate claw slugs in this tomb. They're horrific things. Mouths bigger than your head. I've lost 3 squads of good men fighting them. They come in packs. They'll swallow a man whole.
Death is a way of life.
Yes, sir. But the mission is in danger of failing. Sending more men isn't the answer. The damn claw slugs breed so fast there's no way to wipe them out conventionally. So we started targeting their egg chambers. They went insane. We managed to get explosives to all of the egg chambers, but the claw slugs were all over us before we could detonate them.
Perhaps I could be of assistance.
Don't underestimate those claw slugs, sir. They're smarter than they look. I heard the explosions when you set off the charges. Outstanding, sir.
Acolyte, I come with a message. Overseer Tremel can teach you the ways of the Sith, but not all of the skills. For that, there are specialists in the Academy. Overseer Tremel wishes you to meet them and learn what you can.
The pure blood in your veins gives you a very attractive coloring.
To even touch a pure blood woman, you must prove that the Sith runs strong through your muddied veins. A Sith woman only respects power. Go. Someday you may learn enough to impress me. If not, kill me. You will find the best trainers in the Academy's archive. You are expected there shortly.
Strong, but you could be stronger. Show no mercy.
Hey there, Acolyte. Hold on a moment. Let me get a look at you. So you're Overseer Tremel's secret weapon. Impressive, to be sure. Afraid the old man waited too long to make his move, though. I'm Vemrin, and unlike you, I've fought and bled for everything I have. I demand respect.
You don't want to make me angry, Vemrin.
Believe it or not, I'm trying to keep you from getting killed. If Overseer Tremel had made his move a year ago when I first arrived, he might have had a chance. But now, too little, too late.
This is ridiculous, Vemrin. Let's just kill him and hide the body.
We're not on Balmora anymore, Dolgus. There are rules, traditions. We'll leave the shortcuts to Overseer Tremel and his last pathetic hope here.
I'm going to take what's yours, and then I'm going to kill you.
You have no idea the enemy you're making. Coming, Dolgus?
Be right there, Vemrin. Listen to me, you useless priss. Acolytes aren't allowed to murder each other, but accidents happen. It isn't murder without witnesses. No more warnings. Vemrin's the alpha monster here. You go after Vemrin, you die.
Good. You've returned. You seem to be in one piece. Tell me, how do you like your new blade?
I hope it's thirsty. I plan on drowning it.
What are you doing, Father? I only just got my war blade and I've been here 6 months.
I have my reasons, Escala. And you will not breathe a word of this to anyone. Do you hear?
Yes. Yes, Father.
Acolyte, this is Escala, my daughter. She's one of the advanced students here, on her way to becoming Sith, if she minds herself.
I'll keep quiet about your new charge, Father, but I won't be there if whatever you're planning blows up in your face.
Don't mind her, she's just sore that I'm keeping secrets. She growls, but she's loyal. Now, I thought I heard Vemrin's voice in the adjacent chamber before you arrived. Did he make his move so soon?
Yeah, I hate him already. I look forward to ending his miserable existence.
If things go well, you will have that satisfaction someday. Still, I'd hoped we'd have more time. Vemrin's not the type to sniff around for too long before trying to take a bite. In a drive for sheer numbers, the criteria for Academy admittance has been relaxed. Now anyone with Force sensitivity is allowed entrance. Vemrin is mixed blood, the invisible rot eating at the foundation of the Empire. He must not be allowed to advance.
So, you're an elitist snob.
You say that like it's a bad thing. It's the Sith way. Only the best, only the most pure, should be good enough. Unfortunately, Vemrin's caught the eye of Darth Barriss, one of the most influential Sith lords. He's being groomed to be Barriss's new apprentice. As Darth Barriss's apprentice, the power at Vemrin's fingertips will be considerable. He could change the Sith for the worse. You must proceed to your next trial immediately. I want you to interrogate 3 prisoners in the Academy jails and decide their fates. Consider each criminal's story carefully. The decisions you make will be scrutinized, so let your passions guide your judgments.
Scrutinized? Who presumes to judge my actions? You.
Of course. When Darth Barriss catches wind of you, it's going to be my neck on the line as much as yours. Go to the Academy prison. Speak to head jailer Nash and return to me after you've passed judgment on the prisoners.
One more chirp from you, little bird, and you'll regret it.
Chirp, chirp, chirp. Ow, jerk. If you don't like that, just say so. I can do other animals too. Dire cat, frog dog, quaking monkey lizard, You name it.
You, I'm Jaylen Nash. I run these cells in slave pits. You're the acolyte Tremel sent for the test, right? He thinks highly of you.
That's good to hear. I want to do well.
You should know this situation is highly unusual. Normally an acolyte goes off well for the interrogation. Overseer Tremel, had these three shipped in for you. He thinks you're the next coming of Exar Kun. But you ought to know, Tremel ain't the only one paying attention to you. Now, these three prisoners have been transferred here for your inspection. You gotta interrogate them as needed, and then decide their fate. The convicted are usually executed or given a trial by combat to see if they're worthy. Whatever you decide, you will be the one to carry out the sentence.
I was hoping this would keep me entertained.
Fine. Let's get started. This one on the left.
You freaks aren't getting anything new out of me. Just do whatever you're gonna do.
You can either talk to me or to the Inquisitors, and I promise, I have a much sunnier disposition.
Get lost. I've been through this routine. I already know all your Inquisitors by name.
Impudent to the last. As I was saying, she was sent to kill an Imperial spy in the Yavin system. Throughout her torture, she maintained that she was hired anonymously.
Get it through your damn head! I had no idea he was Imperial, and I don't know who hired me!
So you're telling me you're not a Republic assassin?
I'm not political. I work for whoever pays.
The point is, she doesn't deny the charge. So now you must decide, execution or trial by combat. Which do you choose?
Neither, actually. She could prove useful. Send her to Imperial Intelligence.
I won't work for free.
You spared her. Interesting.
Please, I am a fellow Sith. Judge me with an open mind and grant me trial by combat, I beg you.
Your name, now.
This part of Waste is Davotek. Once a valued Sith champion, until he botched an important mission and caused 1,000 Imperial deaths. Now look at him.
I served faithfully for 24 years. Then one mistake, and they threw me away. Now I have been left here to rot. Please, let me feel the weight of a weapon once more.
I will grant your wish. A warrior should die with his boots on.
My thanks, young warrior.
This should be entertaining. Well, he didn't put up much of a fight, did he?
Died a warrior.
Well, this last prisoner's a bit of a puzzle. He's called Breg, and he's a jittery little wretch, suspected of supplying forged documents to Republic agents. Strangely enough, he maintains his innocence, despite being severely tortured.
Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila magnam unya kamnalebik.
Come on, who would go to all the trouble of setting you up?
Nibikat nakamak! Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila magnam unya kamnalebik.
He's never wavered from that line. And the evidence is circumstantial. I suppose it's actually possible he didn't do it. So, what do you decide?
I don't care if he's innocent or not. Torture him enough and he'll confess.
Shut up, you fidgety fool. The decision's been made. Well, that's that. You're an interesting one, kid. I can see why people are keeping tabs on you. Head back to Overseer Tremel. See what he thinks of your choices.
Thank you.
Is this everything?
Everything Lord Renning was able to obtain, yes.
Then run back to your master in the beast pens before I cut you in half. Sorry to make you wait, Acolyte. These interruptions are incredibly annoying. On to the business at hand, your test in the jails. First, the assassin, Solence. She attempted to kill an Imperial spy, but was unaware of her client's affiliation. You assigned her to Imperial Intelligence. I commend you, that was excellent thinking. Never waste a potential resource.
Of course, the answer was obvious.
Obvious to you, but not to many who have come before you. Now, Devotec, the failed warrior, why grant his wish for a trial by combat?
I did it out of respect for his service. He used to be a potent warrior.
We don't have time to honor yesterday's accomplishments. Devotec was an utter waste of space. Once something is no longer useful, it should be eradicated. Remember that. Lastly, the forger you sent back for more torture, even though he seemed innocent. A strong decision. Leave no stone unturned.
And what if it turns out he truly is innocent?
It's always best to know beyond any doubt. After all, what is one man's sanity or life versus the fate of the Empire? You're beginning to understand what it means to be Sith, but you're far from being able to impress Darth Barriss.
I'll try harder, Overseer, I promise.
If you don't, you're doomed. Remember that. Because I forced you into the Academy ahead of schedule, Darth Barriss will be predisposed to judging you severely. And by severely, I mean fatally. Now, we must hurry to your next trial. Every moment that passes, we risk discovery before we're ready. In the caverns of Mark Aragnos is the beast he left to guard his legacy. Go there, sit among the flames, and wait for the beast to come for you.
Sounds like a good opportunity for violence.
Hold nothing back. This creature is doom itself. Return to the Valley of the Dark Lords and find the tomb of Mark Aragnos. I'll see you when the beast is slain. Good luck.